Today we are going to do on today classes on law of conservation of linear momentum, and you all know linear momentum is what? Mass into velocity. But we are doing with the law of conservation of linear momentum, and according to the law of conservation of momentum, we have even in the presence of an external force, suppose if there is no external force, what we really find that if there is no external force acting on the system, then the total momentum is conserved. So we are going to start with this, we are going to prove this, and in order to prove this, we'll consider two bodies, so two particles. Let us assume we have taken two particles of masses m1 and m2. Okay, there are two particles of masses m1 and m2, and here that individual momentum is p1 vector and p2 vector. P1 and p2 vector are the momentum of it. Okay, as a result, the total momentum on the system, the total momentum for the entire system, p vector is equals to p1 vector plus p2 vector. Okay, now suppose if we consider F1 vector and F2 vector as the two forces acting on the masses M1 and M2, then what we really find that, and if we consider delta P1 vector and delta P2 vector as the change net, as the change in momentum, we are considering this as the change in momentum. Okay, so what we really find, change in momentum, what we really find that delta P vector is equals to delta P1 vector plus delta P2 vector. Okay, so yahan, if I divide it by delta t, let us assume, or next step, let us divide it by delta t. So it is delta p1 vector by delta t plus delta p2 vector by delta t. So here we have the limit. If the limit delta t tends to 0, delta p vector by delta t can be written as dp by dt. We write it as dp by dt. Okay, so if we have the limits delta t tending towards 0 for the entire one, we can also write delta p1 vector by delta t is equals to dp1 vector by, for the limit delta t tending towards 0 as dt, as well as same goes for limit delta p2 by delta t, limit delta t tending towards 0, we write it as dp2 by dt. So we have written this. Okay, now here what we find that this is equals to f1 vector and this is equals to f2 vector. So we have this condition, right? So what we really find that f1 vector is what? F1 vector is equals to f1 external plus f1 vector internal. Okay, and f2 vector is equals to f2 vector external plus f2 vector internal, right? So what we can write, dp vector by dt is equals to f1 external plus f1 internal plus f2 vector external plus f2 vector internal. Okay, so we can segregate this. This becomes f1 vector external plus f2 vector external plus f1 vector internal plus f2 vector internal. We can separate it. So what we are getting up, we have separated the term, but here what we find that the internal part that forms an action and reaction pair, here what we find that f1 internal plus f2 internal is equals to 0. Why? Because f1 internal is equals to minus f2 internal, that is equal and opposite. So what we find that the total f external is equals to 0, or we can write, since f vector is external vector is 0, so we can write that dp vector by dt is equals to 0. So we have reached this condition, that is the total, we can see that if there is no external force acting on the system, the total internal force is becoming 0. So if there is no external force acting on the system, then the rate of change of momentum becomes equals to 0. So what does it states that it, if it is 0, it simply shows that p vector is constant. So this gives an idea that In the absence of an external force, the total momentum of a system remains constant and does not change with time. So this gives us a very basic information that in the absence of any external force, the total momentum of a system remains constant and does not change with time. So in two dimensional, we can write this as dp vector x by dt is equals to f vector x, and we have dp vector y by dt is equals to f vector y. Okay, so here if we find that if y vector is equals to 0 and f vector the fx vector is not equals to 0, then what we infer that if fy vector is equals to 0 and if we have fx vector not equals to 0, then means py vector is equals to a constant. Okay, so this is another very important thing that we got to know from this. I hope it is clear for you to understand that the law of conservation of linear momentum. Now the question is that where we apply the linear momentum condition, where we are going to apply this condition. Now the first one is the recoil of a gun. When a bullet is fired from a gun, the gun gives a large velocity to the bullet in the forward direction. Okay, as the bullet acquires momentum in the forward direction, the bullet also exerts a reactionary force on the gun, which is pushed back. And according to this, an equal momentum in the backward direction. So this what you really find that here we are using up the condition for the recoil of a gun. There we are using it up. Then we have got next is the earth and the ball. Second one is the earth and the ball. Let us assume a ball is falling towards the earth, or we can say that a falling ball is attracted by the earth. Therefore, the velocity and hence the momentum of the ball will keep on increasing in the downward direction. Now, the ball also in the same condition, if the earth is attracting the ball, that simply means the ball is also attracting the earth with the same force and the momentum. This also increases in the same rate in the upward direction. That's the total that if we consider the momentum of the ball and the earth as a system, it is conserved. But the mass of the earth is too large and hence the velocity of the earth is negligible. So in this case, we don't see the velocity of the earth because of the huge mass of the earth. So this is one of the examples. Then we have got another example, jumping from boat to the shore. There also we are using the law of conservation of linear momentum. We use law of conservation of linear momentum for the flight of a rocket, and we also use in many places for the explosion of bomb. So these are the places where we are using the law of conservation of linear momentum. I hope things are very clear. You might have understood what is the law of conservation of linear momentum. So it is simply says that if there is no external force acting on the system, the total momentum of the body remains conserved. So this is all about the law of conservation, and we use this law of conservation of linear momentum in solving numerical problems. So when I'll be discussing the numerical problem, there we are going to discuss all these things there. Thank you for watching.